The Blackwater estuary on the coast of Essex. A place where land meets sea and human and natural processes interact. The estuary forms an environment of diverse habitats and species and is an area used in a variety of ways. It's a flatland of marshes, creeks and mudflats used for fishing, farming and recreation. But it's the relationship between the sea and the land that is fundamental. A relationship that may at first seem predictable until nature unleashes a freak event which can upset the whole balance. By looking more closely at this relationship, we can begin to understand the themes of change, contest, and response that enable us to explore the environment. The first of these, the theme of change, emphasizes the dynamic relationship between land and sea over time.
When we're talking about change, if we look at just the last 100 years, the last two generations of people, They would have seen, first of all, a salt marsh out here in North Sea, and then the salt marsh washed away and it became a mudflat, and then the mudflat went and it became a beach. So these changes are taking place all the time, and change is the order of the day. Change is what coasts are about. When people look at a coastline like this, they think that it's always been the same, that this is static. In actual fact, only 10,000 years ago, a microsecond of geological time, this was part of a freshwater system with the Thames came sweeping right the way up here. And if we go forward in time from then, from those big changes at the end of the last ice age, if we went out there now and we went out a mile on that mud, when the tide goes down you can go a mile out, you'll come across 4,000 year old oak forests when it was dry land. 400 years ago, this bit of sea, which is right by the beach, had sheep grazing on it. Then we come to the 14th century, the mini ice age came. Sea level had stopped rising or was static. That's when all the sea walls went in. And it's during that period that man realised the importance of using this coast, particularly for agricultural gain.
At the mouth of the Blackwater is the 7th century Saxon chapel of St Peter, itself on the site of a Roman fort. Here, Kevin Bruce describes the impact of humans on the local landscape.
The most significant factor in this has been human changes. It's been the desire of man to reclaim natural salt marsh for agricultural purposes. So the landscape we have here is very much a man-made landscape. The farmers found it beneficial to reclaim the land here because previous to them building any seawalls at all, twice a day the saltings would have been flooded by the tides. They found these saltings extremely good for pasturing sheep. And Doomsday Book records that hundreds of sheep were kept on the Essex marshes all round the Essex coast.
And from the Middle Ages right up to the 19th century, more and more land was being recovered from the sea.
It's been a constant process. What these farmers discovered on building a new sea wall, then they changed the tidal patterns. The sea was beginning to slow down and enable deposition to take place further out on the saltings. And it's actually recorded in many of the documents that the farmers reckoned that within 5 or 10 years of building a sea wall, there would be new fresh saltings for them to enclose. And so bit by bit, they must have pushed out the level of the saltings. And when they found it convenient, they would enclose them to produce new land. You can actually see from the maps how far the saltings extended.
But once the sea level began to rise, the situation changed again.
And as time went on, and the ice age, the mini ice age ended in about 1860, and so this coastline here, which would have been then salt marshes by now because the sea's come up a bit, and there was no beach here then. In fact, this beach, even in the 1930s, was a little tiny narrow strip. And as the mud is washed away, so the coarse material gets washed ashore and forms these beaches. And then behind us, we get these kind of reed beds forming. And you have to bear in mind that in between the reed bed there, and you have trees behind it and houses on the top, that cliff was a sea cliff in Saxon times. So sea level is always going up and down. since the end of the last ice age, but with a steady and consistent trend upwards, and you can't stop that.
Mm-hmm.